Pennsylvania. The AWA will be there. You'll be watching for us also in Atlanta, Georgia. I can't wait to get to Atlanta. The jewel of the South, make no mistake about that. Also in Canada, San Francisco, and of course Hawaii, a great place to go this time. What do you want, Mr. Paul E. Dangerously?
You know, Mr. Nelson, everybody in the wrestling world is talking about the same thing. Tommy Rich, Wildfire Tommy Rich, the former NWA World Heavyweight Champion, being put down on the mat, getting a dress stuck on him, and having lipstick put all over his face by the adorable Adrian Adonis and yours truly, Paul E. Dangerously. And as you may know, Mr. Nelson, during a three-day vacation in North Hollywood, Paulie Dangerously, Adrian Adonis, Loverboy Dennis, and Ravishing Randy, we went to a party like you wouldn't believe, and everybody was coming up to us and saying, okay, nice going, guys. I mean, Robin Leach was there, man, going, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Lord Styles of the Rich and Dangerous. And Billy Crystal goes up to Adrian and goes, I tell you, darling, what you do to Tommy Rich was absolutely marvelous. There was a Chinese guy there, Rocky Aoki from New York, came in, Benny Hanna going, oh, what you did, that was okay, nice going. Everybody's talking about it, because what we did has never been done before to a former world heavyweight champion. Even Adrian's friends going, that was pretty nasty. You see, what we did has set the wrestling world on fire. People now coming back to the arenas, paying money to see us. Because Tommy Rich messed with the Dangerous Alliance. He messed with Adrian. He messed with Dennis. He messed with Randy. And he messed with me. You don't mess with the Dangerous Alliance. Because we're the baddest mothers in professional wrestling today. And I don't care where you are. If we got Tommy Rich, you come on and see him in his final match.
Jerry Blackwell. Oh, they love him. Look at the sign. This is supposed to depict, I am guessing, Madusa Michelli, who is the manager of Killer Kelly, Mr. Magnificent. You see her there, decked out in white leather jacket, short skirt, boots. Not too bad, Ray, the Crippler Stevens.
I tell you what, she's a super, super looking lady, and she's got a mean streak in her, just as pretty as she is, too.
I think he likes her, too.
Oh, yeah. But this is one of the TV tournament matches here. You know, if you win, you get 5 points. If you lose, you get 5 points. You get so many points if you're disqualified, if you win by disqualification, you go backwards on points if you get disqualified or lose. And the AWA is keeping track of these points. They're just going to determine after 3 months who is going to be the television champion by whoever's winning the most points in these television matches.
And it could well be one of these two. You have just seen close-ups of both Jerry Blackwell and Kevin Kelly.
Well, Mr. Kelly's going to have his hands full with Jerry Blackwell. He's about 400 pounds and a tremendous wrestler on top of it.
476.
Almost 500 pounds then.
Kelly bangs him into that turnbuckle. That's all. The one thing that I'm concerned about here, there you get a good look at Madusa, the manager of Mr. Magnificent. We'll just let that picture speak for itself. It has. We see Nick Kiniski over on the side. And somehow, some way, I've just got a terrible, terrible feeling. The fat man is going to be involved in this match before it is over, and Jerry Blackwell may pay a big, big price. We will have to wait and see.
I don't think he would risk getting suspended or anything to involve himself in this right now. You know, the president of the AWA, Mr. Blackbird, sitting here watching him tonight, so they better be a little careful what they're doing.
Right alongside me, as a matter of fact.
You know, earlier this evening, Rod, we saw Dirty Dick Slater.
Yes.
And as you noticed, Kurt Hennig came to the ring with him. And,
speaking of partners, yes, or seconds.
As a bounty hunter, I'm just wondering if Kurt Hennig's got something in the back of his mind being the world champion. Oh!
Jerry Blackwell!
Oh, what a headbutt. He knocked him completely through those ropes that time.
Blackwell is back. Wow, is he ever.
Well, I never thought I'd see Jerry Blackwell posing, but he's posing for Mr. Kelly in there. And I knew this from the start that Mr. Magnificent Kevin Kelly would have his hands full with Jerry Blackwell. Oh!
Nick Kiniski started to make his way into the ring shortly after Kelly went out. And that's what you saw Blackwell motioning. Come on, come on. I'll take you as well.
Come on, come on.
There you see Madusa Nick Kelly. And you had a bit of a look also at Nick Kiniski.
Well, you know, Kiniski out there with Madusa, maybe they think that they're going to psych Jerry Blackwell out, but he's too much of a veteran to fall for that.
I was just going to ask you the question. Would you shake Killer Kelly's hand?
Absolutely not.
Look at
oh.
that! Holy cow!
Tell you what, this is a great match. A good competition here. You couldn't get any better than this.
Whoa.
You know, we have wrestlers coming to the
AWA. Look at Jerry Blackwell. Out of sight. Go to it, Jerry. Do it.
We have wrestlers coming here from the WWF, from the NWA, because of the competition and how great it is. And that's what they like about the AWA. And here you're seeing a great example of it.
And Gene Kiniski. Nick. Gene was his father. Nick is in that number, in that group as well now. Hard knee lift for the solar plexus by Mr. Magnificent. Forearm smash. Again, forearm smash on Jerry Blackwell. The whip. Oh!
Oh! I tell you what. He's got Blackwell reeling there. Oh, he's putting
down. There he goes. He may have it. Cover. The count by the referee. But Blackwell's arm is outside that lower rope.
It's never over till it's over, and you can't count Blackwell out very easy.
That you are, Yogi. Jerry Blackwell, the mountain from Stone Mountain. He is a big, big, big man. It takes him longer to recover than another person.
Oh!
Look at Kelly.
Oh! What power.
Oh!
What power.
Here comes Kelly again with an elbow. And now the hook of the leg and the cover.
Oh! I'm going to tell you, that hurt Jerry Blackwell. I don't believe I have ever seen him slam before, Rod.
A double sledge to the back by Mr. Magnificent. What a war is going on right here on the shores of the Showboat in Las Vegas, Nevada. Listen to the crowd. It's hand-to-hand combat. Blackwell is cut on the forehead.
You can't tell this Mr. Magnificent Kevin Kelly short either. I'll tell you, he is one powerful man.
Look at this.
Oh!
A Blackwell clothesline.
Uh-oh.
Here's Kiniski. Brought into the ring by Blackwell. Headbutt by Blackwell. And now, hello there.
They are going to get disqualified, I'll guarantee you.
Blackwell hammering away and Kiniski. Here comes Killer Kelly from behind with a knee into the kidneys and a smash from behind the head. And now it is both Kiniski and Kelly on Blackwell. And this has got to be stopped.
They have been disqualified. The bell was rang. Uh-oh. Here comes Jerry Blackwell back down. I'll tell you what, Nick Kiniski must have felt that Kevin Kelly had all he could handle.
Here comes referee Bob Warren. Come here, Bob. What? He threw the match out. He threw the match out with both Kiniski and Kelly going on that man. And that man is the man who is left standing inside the ring. Let's look again. There's the headbutt. And now the crunch. Bingo. We're at the Showboat. Hooray, the